Okay, there goes.
Alright guys, so what's up though? I'm finally back though today. I got a quick Dragon Ball video I want to do. Nothing really that long though, but we did get some new stuff, of course. Vegeta Gohan's banner is live on global. All they did change, all the different unit-wise, they just changed Pink Goku Black. That's literally it. Literally it. Because we're gonna show some stuff off of my phone as well. But yeah, Pink Goku Black is on the banner now. It's just not hit. It's basically literally, I want to say one for one. Let me just check right here. Like, literally, almost one for one, that's the unit change. That's really it. That's really it. Just in Goku Black. But I do not recommend summoning on the banner. Do not summon on this banner. You people will be like, oh, I'm going to save my stones. Blah, 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 blah. I want to summon on this banner because Vegeta Gohan, he is great. But I do not recommend. He's awesome. I love Vegeta Gohan. I don't care. Still one of my favorite Gohans to this day. But I do not recommend summoning on that banner. Do not summon on that banner. You're killing yourself. I'd rather say Saber STR Cooler for crying out loud. I feel like he's gonna be the next Dokkan Fest for global. I'm trying to think Android 13, but after this we have like STR Cooler, Android 13, the AGL one, and after that we have like the two Super Saiyan 2 Goku and Vegeta. They're transforming into Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku and Tech Roger Vegeta. I think that's literally it for global. Like those are the only Dokkan Fest we have. And of course filler stuff they haven't brought in yet, but of course. Then down here, this is the main feature. I do not recommend. Do not summon on this banner. Your Goku's been back 1,000 times. Super Vegito has been back 1,000 times. I know he was just, I mean, I'll be reminded. This Vegeta Gohan and this one, they link really well. Trunks is good. He's great. He's really underrated because of transformation, but he's Goku Black is still good, but I do not recommend going for that banner. Even for coins, I don't recommend doing this because you're just killing yourself overall. Then, of course, right here, I want to say, what was this? Okay, 7-man EZA is actually live on global. I think it was this 7-man EZA. This is the best EZA in the game. I do like this EZA because half these units are great. Medical, especially this Goku, this Vegeta, they're all good. Like, they're all really good. Like, all these guys, they're all good. I am going to make a separate video on it, of course, because, you know, I tend to do all this stuff for every EZA on global because, you know, global has different units and stuff like that. But they honestly, they are weak to the Gigi Force category. I know I'm going over it in this video, but they are legit weak to the Gigi Force category. But of course, though, that is really, I mean, this EZA, I love this EZA. I love all these units on here. I love this Goku. I love him so much. Like, him and Metacooler are great. And after that, I do love Nova Shenron. They're all good in their own way. I'm going to go over all of them, of course. In a separate video, I tend to do this type of stuff. I don't care. It's my way of doing it. Don't judge me. Don't toy with me. But of course, now that we have, I love Vegeta Blue. His campaign is actually live on global. This one, I'm not going to make a separate video for because it's super simple. I know a lot of, like, story events are back as well for this, but of course, you know, basically, you know, the typical LR Vegeta Blue campaign, you do get 20 stones, I think, or something like that. We get a whole bunch of stones right here, by the way, too. I don't feel like Vegeta Gohan might hit number one on the App Store. I feel like he probably won't. A lot of people are still thinking that. Him himself is good, but I don't think they're going to hit number one. Also, time for EXP is back until what? Dang, that's almost, like, until JP's anniversary, so, yeah, I recommend. I'm about to grind up. Like, I'm not even joking. Like, right now, it is actually live. Let me turn down my brightness. For you guys, it might be like this. Look, times 4 EXP is back. You guys can see it right there. Times 4, I'm not even joking. That is back on global. Then, of course, right here, you know, the Gohan banner is up as well. I do not recommend going for his banner. Do not summon. Do not summon. Even with the red coins. Give me a minute. Do not get any of these units. They're all good in their own ways, but do not do it. Don't do it. But of course, you know, time for EXP is back. So I always recommend doing that. Because, you know, it's going to be back for the anniversary, you know, as well. But I recommend doing that now. And of course, we have more, you know, new Batar mails. I did like 50 videos on those back in the day. I still remember those. Then, of course, you know, all the regular story events are back as well. I do recommend farming, especially this one. You can farm a Gogeta Super Tech early. And you can also farm a Vegeta's, I think. Like, yeah, that one's back. So basically, you can farm these out until, like, you know, I mean, because this ends around kind of same time their anniversary kind of ends for part one, I want to say, for JP. But of course, you know, farm out the super attack now. Do it now so you don't have to do it later. You're going to thank me. Trust me, I did have tech hit. I do not regret it. Then, of course, right here, I want to say just the legendary campaign, you know, missions. But, you know, all the prime battle events are all going to be up right now. So if you haven't farmed out tech cell, go ahead. You can do it right now. Do it. Go do it now. But of course, you know, typical stuff. I mean, they're all going to be available, I think, every week now, of course, but typical stuff. I'm trying to think, what was this one? Let me think. I think these were just, come on. Okay, there it goes. I think this one's just like, you know, all the future going. These are all the new characters as well, all the new free play units. They're good as well, Android 17, 18. They're basically the same unit, but they're really good. And of course, we have this new future going. You're going to need all these units for the EZA area. It's coming for Trunk. That should be on the 9th. Day Kaioken Blue Goku's EZA is going to be on the 9th as well, of February. So that should be up as well. And then, of course, right here we have Legendary Campaign. These are all Vegeta prizes. Of course, from the early, that's 30 stones right there for you. I always told people to do already because, you know, give them rainbows and stuff like that, of course, so you can get those extra rewards. Same thing goes for TXL. Do it now. Do it now. You're going to thank me later. Trust me. I mean, you really are going to just thank me later. I see people in the comments. I read every comment, people, and I answer it. Trust me. If you comment on this video, you're going to see me answer it. And of course, you know, we had the story event back as well for, you know, the hope against, the fight against despair. I said fight against hope. Fight against bacon of hope. Though, of course, you know, all the story events are back and stuff like, oh, we can farm aiders. There you go. Of course, it's back in revamp. You can use the Future Saga category units. That's great. From a gravity chambers, of course, all these units are back up and everything like that. It's great. I'm glad they revamped it. It looks nice. It looks awesome. Of course, you do need guys for the easy areas, of course. And from my other super attacks. There you go. And of course, right here on JPX, they do have a new Battlefield up right now. It's the 5e anniversary on Battlefield. I was going to do this in a separate video, but I was like, I'll just cram it into here because it's really short. Of course, you know, we got, like, you know, Paragus and Bardock, you know, it's going to do Dragon Ball Super Broly and, like, the Future Trunks arc. It's kind of going back and forth between those. But, yeah, of course, there's all the missions and stuff like that, of course. You know, a little short thing. That's really awesome right there. I recommend doing this, too, on JP. That's more free stones. And look, another sticker right there. There you go. I mean, you just got to clear, like, a few times. But that's still good, though. Of course, this is the 7-man EZA right here. One of the best EZAs in the game. I still love TXL. And, you know, go to Facebook, too. Of course, they are weak to the game first category. I will make a separate video on this completely, though. I don't know when I'm going to upload it, though. I'm going to upload it straight. But, of course, you know, they are weak to the game first. I know everything's not loading right now. But, of course, they are weak to the game first category. So, that's great and everything like that. I mean, it's super simple. You can easily build the game first team. Whichever units you want to go with. I mean, it doesn't really matter because they're all good anyway. So, yeah, still one of the best free play teams of the day. But, yeah, that's all I just really want to go with today. We got lots of new stuff for Global and JP. We got a lot of new things. Especially for Global right now, it was kind of dead. From my 4x rank EXP, from my everything on JP right now, we got lots of new stuff. Battlefield, all good junk. Do not summon on the banner. You're going to kill yourself. Trust me. I would say Saber FTR Cool if you wanted to. That banner is really good because Cool is still one of the best units in the game. I still love him. Also, save for the anniversary units. Do it because you will thank me later. You will thank me later. So yeah, see you guys later. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day, great life, all that cool junk. See you guys later. Peace out. Yeah, I think I got my point through.